against the metal fret, I have this on my finger that I press against the string, and that's how I keep the notes continuing after the fretboard is done. So once you've got that song I just did, everything's all groups of five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Questions about anything? Well, I see if I can just kind of fatten up the sound a little bit. Is what it is. No. Questions? Anything? No. Nothing. All right, then. Nice knowing you. Goodbye. yes. The fretless. Hang on a second. What?
How do you? What do you kind of like playing on the fretless guitar? The sounds that you can't really get out.
What do I like about the fretless that's different from the fretted? Yeah. Why do I like it? Well, shiny. You can do a lot with it. One thing, you can take chords and you can drag on an entire chord. It's like having a sled on every fingertip. So. Chirped harmonics and stuff, and drag those around. Let's see if I can even get them on the sound. Those kind of things, like the just the expression to it with the overtones as you slide up, which is an old Tony Franklin bass thing where you hit a harmonic, and then as it's ringing, push it down and drag it. So it's that whole idea. Stuff like that, you can get a lot of dissonance that are a little bit tougher to get when you have the preciseness of a fret in your way. As an example. On this thing, you can get that. But then you could get them off a little bit from each other so that they growl, but then waves clash with each other. You can go bend on it. You just slide to whatever you would normally bend to. So over here, you know, you got So you can do all of that stuff. You can take it a lot farther bending the note. Then you could, So you could do all of that with it. So it's a nice, fun little thing. And, you know, you could get all stupid with it and just have fun. Anything you would bend, you can can do that. Or if you would give it a little bar dive instead of going up. So, yeah, it's you have all that free play on the string. So it's good. The only thing you gotta do is just practice getting used to aligning your eyes, your ears, and your hands so that everything is in tune. But if a cellist can do it, you can do it on a guitar. Harmonics in particular.
Like the ones that you were demonstrating on the fretless?
Like the sort of chirpy ones, there's a few ways to get harmonics. First of all, you gotta understand what a harmonic is. Okay. A string from here to here is vibrating. If you take the length of any length of string, you cut it exactly in half, that is the spot, that halfway point would be your octave, and if you touch it there, you'll get the next harmonic, it'll double the frequency, and you double the frequency, you add half the length. It's like this reciprocal thing. So one half the length is twice the frequency. So 110, exactly one half the length of the string is 12 frets up, and that's 220. If you go to one third the length of the string, that is the seventh fret, and it's three times the frequency, 330. So 110, 220, 330. And that's the whole length, half the length, a third of the length. And then the other third of the length would be from that 7th fret point to 12 frets higher than that, which is the 19th fret. There it is. So those are the two division points that give you the 1/3 of the exact lengths of the string that gives you three times the frequency. So if you touch the string at those points, just as it's vibrating, it'll bring out that frequency. So you have those. So here's the thing now. You got to remember that there's no such thing as a closed note or an open note. It's just that the guitar is holding it down for you right here. If it's not this, this is your extra kind of finger that's just sitting there. Once you do this, now the string is only vibrating from here to here. Everything is the same. 12 frets higher than this, it's still going to be the halfway point of the length of the string, and it's still going to be twice the frequency. If you go to 1/3 the length of the string, it's still going to be 7 frets higher than that, and 12 frets higher than that. If you go to 1/4 the length of